Hello everybody, welcome back to programming in python.com. Here in this video I'm going to show you how to find a palindrome number. Actually, a number is said to be palindrome if its reverse is the same as itself. Suppose a number like 121, actually if we reverse it and write it, it is also 121. So these type of numbers like 121, you can write 12221 and 1 2 2 2 1, so that reverse and the reverse of the number and the original number is the same. So that type of numbers are called palindrome numbers. So we'll check here whether the given number is a palindrome number or not. So let's get started. First, what we need to do is I'll ask the user to enter some number, something like this. So just like this, I'll ask the user to enter any number. So we will check whether this number is palindrome or not. So first we need to find the reverse of this number. So if the reverse of this number and this number is same, you will say that the number is palindrome. So first we'll store this number value in some other variable, so that we'll compare this variable and that reverse of the variable, something like val, and I will store it as num. So now I'll check, now I can reverse this number and compare this reverse with this variable. So if both are equal, we'll say that number is palindrome, else we'll say the number is not a palindrome. So what we need to do is here, so we'll find the reverse. For finding the reverse, what we can do is, there is a function, pretty simple function, which is available in strings. So what we'll do is, we'll first convert this number to string. So now this number is converted to string, and in strings, if you do this slice operation, so this will use as a reverse of the number. So this is a slice operation. If you want to know about more about slice operations, I have explained this in some other videos, so please check it. This is known as advanced slice. The way we give the, this is the first and this is the last. If we give the first and last as empty and give the step as -1, it will reverse the entire string. So now we have got the reverse of this number. So what we'll do is, we'll just compare this this variable with the value. So what we'll do is, if val equal to equal to, so if this value equal to this reverse of the number, we'll say that the number is palindrome number. So we'll say the given number is palindrome, else we'll just, the given number is not a palindrome, else we say the given number is not a palindrome. So this program will run pretty fine, but here we are converting this to string. So what would be the problem is, here in the input, if the user enters the string, even the string is checked for the palindrome. So what we need is, we need only numbers here, the numbers to be reversed. I'll just show an example here. So if I give something like a qwq, so it will say that the given number is palindrome, but we don't need to check the strings here. We need here only the numbers. So for that, what we need to do is, I'll just keep a try block here. Try, and we'll push all this to the one indentation, and I'll, in this try, I'll check whether this is integer or not. So if only if the number is integer, it will continue further. So, and in what we'll do is, in except, so after giving this try block, in other programs we'll use try and catch, but in Python that is known as except. Except, what we'll get is value error, because the, we need only integers. If there is another thing, we'll get the value error. So what we'll do is, we'll just print something like, please enter a valid number that isn't valid, something like that. So this is not a valid number, try again. So now if any other number, if any strings or anything is entered, we'll show this error, and if integer is entered, we'll carry on with the palindrome checking process. And one more thing we need to do is, here we need to compare it with the number, not this value. So now if I run and see this, I'll give some number like 121, and this is a palindrome number. Again, if I run and I see if the number is 1221, this is a palindrome number. And something like some 855447, the given number is not a palindrome. So this is how we find the palindrome number. It's pretty simple. So that's it for the video. If you like these videos, please subscribe to the channel, share it with your friends, give it a like, comment. Stay tuned for more videos from programming and python.com. See you in the next video. Bye bye.